When the Houston Rockets made the move to acquire Chris Paul from the Clippers, I kind of questioned it. Not only did I not like the fact that they gave up Patrick Beverley and Lou Williams, but I just questioned the fit. With James Harden's style of play, I never thought Chris Paul was the one to complement him. Both were extremely ball-dominant players, arguably the two most ball-dominant players in the league aside from Russell Westbrook. I just really couldn't see it working out from the beginning. The logic behind this trade was that when James started to get tired, Chris Paul could start handling the offense. And even though I didn't agree with this, I guess I could kind of see where they're coming from. In fact, I thought Beverley was the perfect complement to James, but we'll save that for another day. Even though they're both ball dominant, it's a little different with the two. CP likes to dribble a lot, and he likes to facilitate and be in control of the offense. On the other hand, James likes to go one-on-one a lot. He's arguably one of the best ISO scorers we've ever seen. Now James, for the past couple seasons, has been putting up historic numbers under D'Antoni's offense. He's been in the top 2 in MVP voting for the past 3 years? He's been on a tear in the regular season, but they haven't really got it together as a team in the postseason. They play a fast-paced style, and they shoot a lot of threes. And the ball is primarily in the hands of CP or James, but 9 times out of 10, it's in James Harden's hands. He's pretty much going one-on-one every single possession, and dishing the ball or scoring depending on how the defense reacts. This has caused CP, a player who's used to having the ball in his hands, to just standing around waiting for the ball to come to him. Now there are many people who think that the Houston Rockets can't win playing like this, me being one of them. Even Kobe agrees. As the Golden State Warriors proved, it's much easier to guard an offense that's stagnant versus one that has a lot of ball movement and player movement. However, with the amount of success they've had in the regular season, and in the postseason to some degree, I don't blame James for thinking that this way of playing can win them a championship. Now the Rockets never had the strongest start to this season. In fact, it wasn't until Chris Paul went down and James Harden went on a historic tear that they started to win a lot of games. This honestly made the situation a lot worse for Chris Paul. He found himself just standing on the wing while James Harden dribbles the ball out. There are many reports that stated that Chris Paul was trying to coach James Harden and the team into moving around more and running more sets. This didn't go too well with James, especially because the team had a lot of success without him, and they would continue to argue about ball and shot distribution. In fact, there's even a report out that when one time Chris Paul was running with the second unit and saw that James Harden was about to check into the game. When he saw this, he told Coach D'Antoni to have James sit on the bench a little longer while he runs with the second unit. This is how you know it's getting bad. In last year's playoffs, when the Rockets took the Warriors to 6 games, and many people thought they would have won had Chris Paul not got injured, I started to second guess myself and think maybe this thing can work. However, they couldn't quite get past the hump, and the tempers between the two started to flare. It ultimately ended up in them losing to the Warriors in Game 6, without KD, which led to the two having a heated argument in the locker room. Now it's just been reported that Chris Paul apparently demanded a trade from the Houston Rockets. Now they apparently have a relationship that's unsalvageable, which is kind of hard to imagine, especially considering you see all them damn State Farm commercials. He apparently told the Rockets to either trade me or trade him. Although both the Rockets and CP3 denied this, this is definitely not a good look. And this makes it hard for the Rockets, because letting go of either one is hard for different reasons. James is one of the best players in the league, and you can't just get rid of a guy like that. Chris Paul, on the other hand, is 34 years old, has lost a step, and is owed a ton of money. There definitely aren't much teams that are willing to take on that contract, regardless of what else they get. Now, regardless of all of this, I do believe the Houston Rockets have a shot at getting this together and becoming contenders, especially because of the injuries that happened to Golden State. But it will be difficult. What do you guys think of this whole situation? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. Alright guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for updates whenever I upload any videos. Till next time.